Sunday, the 19th of June. This week will be all about working through the backlog, starting with the 2 kilograms of build a minifigure parts. As it's all new pieces, it's just a sort and upload. And of course, identifying all the pieces. Since yesterday, it's been itching to get started on it. As yeah, it will be good for lot count and quantity. So I'm really curious to see what value we have lying here. So without further ado, let's get sorting. Sorting is all done. Got some pretty cool new pieces for the store. Nice quantities overall. And even down here, again, more, as it just didn't fit. And yeah, now comes the part of identifying every piece and putting it away. Will take me some time, but I'll give some updates in the meantime. Heads are in here, but I still need to go through them as I wasn't as careful as I should, so probably some of them are mixed up. So far we've gotten 2 orders today, so we'll pick those later, but for now first some breakfast. Made some progress, but still got a long way to go. And yeah, I've paid €300 for it, and on the 6 month sales average, we've surpassed that. So there will be a bit of discount, but still only the pieces I put away are worth the investment. And we've still got a long way to go. So I'm wondering which crazy number will come of it. Made some more progress. We are about halfway done, I'm guessing, if we don't count the heads, as yeah, still need to do those. Still some awesome parts. One in particular I really like is this Puck head. It's so funny. Never seen that before. And some other great accessories. It's getting fuller and fuller. Some of the pieces need a big drawer, so that's pretty insane. But all in all, really nice and high quantities of pieces, so yeah, can't complain. Wall is filling up quite nicely, so still some empty spots here and here, but those will be filled up, of course, also. For now, first some Father's Day thingies, appointment, going to visit my parents, that's what I mean. And yeah, later tonight we'll chop down the rest of this. I'm back at it. We're making some nice progress. Still got a bit to go. And after pulling some orders, but yeah, first let's get on with this. All the cups are empty. Still some parts which need to be added, but it's all single items mostly, so we'll do that later. These were not available in the Bricklink catalog, so yeah, kind of weird, as it is Lego, I think. Oh, you can't see it. I'll check that. So what an amazing sight. All the columns until up there are filled with parts, mostly. Also this side completely full. As we've gotten some orders, I'm just enjoying it for a moment, as after order picking there will be holes again, which is okay, but I think it's a really cool sight to see all the drawers filled up. Good for business also. And yeah, now the Maman Supreme, I don't know how to say it. We've got 1680 parts in 83 lots, about 1.6 kilograms according to Brickstore. And yeah, let's see what the 6 month average value is. I've paid €300 and the 6 month average value is about €1,500. So that's a decent part of the value. Of course, there will be a bit of a sale. So let me see if I can do it. I usually go with 20%. So after the sale, it's €1,255. So still a great part out and an amazing deal. Can't thank Yannick of Zombrix enough for it. I'm done with minifig pieces for today. So yeah, I'm just going to pull the orders and then call it a day probably. And upload the parts to the store, of course. In my quest to empty the cups, I totally forgot about the heads. So they still need to be done also. But that's for a later time. I'm first off to pick some orders. For the store, we're growing slow and steady as always. We've hit 73,000 parts and close to 5,000 lots, 4,900. So yeah, all in all, great progress and we'll get there. And the 100K parts is getting closer and closer. Time to pull some orders. Funny thing about the orders of this weekend so far, they are all going to Germany. So don't know what's the reason for that, but yeah, I don't mind. Oops. Close above my leg, always nice. I've got one more piece than there should be. Oh well, I'll give the customer 10 pieces instead of 9. I don't think he will mind. 3 pieces are always good. And then my inventory checks out again. Not really sure why there was a difference in the inventory to begin with. But yeah, those things happen. I will recount it, of course, after I've done this clip. As we all know, talking and doing multiple things together isn't my strong suit. But if I do it more often, I should get better at it. When I just shot the clip of the full wall, I realized a bit how far I've come since 8 months ago. So yeah, that's pretty crazy if you sometimes stop and think about what you've achieved. And in a fairly short period of time. If you would have told me 8 months ago when I started this YouTube channel and this shop, that I would be where I am today, I wouldn't have believed it, as it's pretty crazy, to be honest. Who would have thought I would have a room with over 1500 drawers and 73,000 parts? That's just, yeah, it's bonkers. don't know how to say it else. And yeah, my ambition still isn't stopping. So yeah, I love this work. It gives me peace of mind when I do it. So I really like that. It's not too difficult to do. I've got everything in my own control. I've got to check. So my inventory isn't correct. I've got one more of these figures than it shows. Don't know how that happened. But better one more than one less. So not complaining. This order is mostly minifigures. And also Shima minifigures, which is really cool. Had those for a while. And yeah, I knew they would move slow. But it's always good to see them go. Two of those. Oh. One more Kai figure. Same with him, probably. With, yeah. B6. Oh, it's all the way down there. One of these. B9. I forgot this one. Yeah. B11. This one, I guess. Yep. Even kijken. B13. Some Kai minifigures. This is a crazy order. I love it. But yeah, I really enjoy doing this. So for me, I won't be stopping anytime soon. But there is one problem. And this room is getting smaller and smaller with the day. Or fuller and fuller. With every day and every crazy opportunity or haul we do. So yeah, there comes a moment where I've gotta see what to do with that. And I'm dreading it a bit. As yeah, I'm not really sure what my other options are for now. But yeah, that's for the future a problem. For now, I've still got some space to grow. But yeah, the space will be getting smaller and smaller. So I gotta get more creative every time I expand the store. I don't like the idea of having a store away from home, as a store away from home, yeah, it gives me travel time. I can't do stuff quickly in between. So not a fan of that, but we'll see. And three of those. So the last two medium or small legs were from the other minifig lots I had. So always good to see the move. And yeah, all the orders are pulled. I've rambled on a bit. Hope you don't mind. And now I'm going to pack them and get them ready for shipping. It's Monday, the 20th of June. And Yeah, I started today with a huge order. It's 1350 pieces and 160 lots. Took me about an hour to pull, but yeah, it's all done. So really happy with it. It's a high value order in that way. So it helps with regaining the liquidity and peace of mind a bit. It's a big order, it's going to the Netherlands, and yeah, thanks for the order and enjoy the pieces. As I was occupied tonight with other things than the store, I didn't do much except pulling that big order and shipping it. I did, however, make a change to how I see which drawers have spaces. I've decided to pull them out a bit so I can see them easier. Saw this in Tinto's shop and decided to implement it myself, as when the drawers are flush in a big wall, you can miss them sometimes. So yeah, one of the changes I made. And tomorrow we will go on with the minifigure heads and minifigure parts again. It's Tuesday, the 21st of June. For today on the schedule is sorting out the builder minifigure heads and yeah, the remaining pieces to get them uploaded. And some more off-camera work. I've installed flat rate shipping about a month and a half ago. And I plotted the costs and what I've paid in Excel, just to get a feel of if it's doable or if it's losing me money. And overall down the line, I've got €113 for shipping and it cost me about €102. So I think the rates for Europe are pretty good right now. So the next step for me is to open up the United States, Canada, and Australia and New Zealand to expand the reach of the store and yeah, start start selling there, so to say. And if I look at my shipping settings, I'm selling to about 45% of the buyers right now. And oops, if I enable, whoops, if I enable those four countries, US, Canada, and New Zealand, I'm expanding my reach to 91% of the buyers. So tonight I'm going to see if the flat rate shipping of €8 is any good, and the free shipping price. I've just made a mock-up to have the settings ready. I just need to figure out the prices to start testing with them and keep track of the orders which do come in, to see what flat rate number for orders to those countries would be good and break even with the shipping costs. But that's more for off-camera work. So yeah, I'm going to start with the shipping and then on to the heads and extra pieces. I've decided for the rest of the world, the other four countries for now might expand to Asia later on with the same settings. But for now, as I'm still a bit anxious, as it's new for me to ship to any of these countries, I rather do it slow and steady, the rollout, as include all the countries at once and take on more risk, so to say. So I've decided for flat rate shipping of €8. And if the order is above €100, it will be shipped for free. So we'll see how it goes. I'll keep a close eye on it, of course. If it doesn't work, I'll just disable it again and rethink it. But it's for me now the perfect time to test it, as we're in the summer slowdown. So the amount of orders I'm expecting is quite low. So we can just wait and see how things go before we really let it pick up. For the world chart, it means I'm selling to 91% of the buyers on BrickLink right now. So that's almost a 50% increase of potential customers. Really curious to see how that goes, but yeah, we'll see. And I've updated the terms and conditions, gave it a nice format in Dutch and English with the new shipping terms, of course. And BrickLink also got the same treatment and new terms. BrickAll, my bad. So yeah, we'll see. I'll keep you updated, of course, how it goes. And if I don't like it, I'm pretty sure I'll disable it sooner than later. We'll see. Heads are all done. Couldn't identify one of them, but the others I did find. I did put them away. And yeah, it's about 77 euros of value again. So this lot is totaling up to around 1600 euros, which is really great. Still got the other parts to go, but yeah, I'm done for today. Got to work tomorrow, so they will move on to a next day. It's Wednesday, the 22nd of June, and we've got two fairly easy orders to pick. Scout Trooper. Need to count them three times. And up here, five times these, yeah, projectiles, arrows. And for now, that's it. Both one lot orders. So nice and easy to pick. And yeah, we're going to pack them. And I'll continue working on my day job as it's my break now. And later tonight, we'll get a move on with something else. It's Thursday, the 23rd of June. And I forgot yesterday totally that it was Wednesday. And on Wednesdays, I don't do anything in the evening for the Lego store because I have private appointments. So yeah, that was my first mistake. My second mistake is I've gotten second to none time today, but I did pull the orders, but I totally forgot to shoot a clip. So yeah, two orders are already packed, nothing out of the ordinary there. One thing to mention is for this order going to Germany, and it's having some of the metallic silver pieces which came from the Mandalorian helmet, which I recently parted out. So it's good to see them move. They move a lot faster than the metallic gold pieces of the Thanos gauntlet, but that's okay. So really grateful for the orders, of course, and I'll get back to you tomorrow. It's Friday, the 24th of June. After two busy days, we're back in the shop to work a bit, as we've done not much. But yeah, I've got three base colors left for the legs: black, blue, and all kinds of grays. I think the grays will be last, as it also has some older colors like old gray. And I expect, whoops, them to be a bit more wanted, so it's better to do the other two colors first. And of course, I still got all these sorted on TE pieces, but yeah, those might go as last, as I'm really expecting those to be very desirable. So we still have got a way to work through. Oh, also got white legs. So, four colors left. But the whites aren't that white, so I'm not really sure if most of them will make the cut, but we'll see. And of course, loads of heads left also, so yeah, still got a long way to go. It's still a bit hard to not buy new sets, as there are a lot of sales right now. But yeah, I'm going to try to stick with the plan of first uploading all these pieces and get through the backlog a bit, as it's quite some value which is still lying around. So a bit to motivate myself, but also I might buy some new sets again to fill up the wall, as it's pretty slashed after the big order of the last week. So yeah, trying to stay strong, but can't promise anything. This is what I managed to salvage from the blue bag of blue legs. It's not much, but these are up to my standards. And yeah, all of this, it just didn't make the cut. I don't know if blue is extra brittle or something, because there were a lot of crack legs and even, yeah, bite marks, but that's from people who put Legos in the mouth, kids probably. And yeah, a lot of yellowing, so not going to sell these. These will be uploaded to the store, and yeah, on another day we'll move on to the another color. Almost forgot, never seen these legs before, so pretty funny they have some springs in them. Yeah, wanted to share that. Saturday, the 25th of June, and today is a day off in the store, as I've gotten a new kitten and I wanna acclimate it properly. So gotta take the time for that and gotta get my other kitten used to it. So that's eating up my time today, but that's okay. Starting next week, I will be working 4 days a week on the day job, and I'm getting the Wednesdays off, so I can spend those on the store and on the backlog, of course. As always, thank you for watching, have a nice week, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye bye.